everyone, welcome to Artful Studio, and this is Anuja, and today I am going to do a Saura painting. So here, when we start a Saura painting, it's very important for us to draw the borders because it follows a fishnet approach. And to make the borders, I used my scale and the compass to do some measurements. So this is basically my format where I will be doing the painting. Now, Saura paintings are the pictographs that are painted on the as wall murals on the adobe huts. The adobe huts were the huts that were made of sun-dried bricks, and as this Saura tribe were the dwellers in the areas of Vasundhara River, next to the Vasundhara River in the hilly forest areas, these paintings were made by the seashell powder, as the seashells were very easily available close to the river. But now here what I have taken is the brown paper, and I am doing it with lamp black. So this is the ink and the brush that I am using. You can also use the pen to do the work. Now generally the borders of the Saura painting are done in geometric forms. I have a full tutorial on it. On the Saura paintings, a 4-day full tutorial, and day 1 talks only about the different types of borders and their authenticity, the symbols. So the pictographs are basically the symbols that they use to make their own pictures. And these pictures were done by only the priest, which is unlike to that art of Warli. In Warli, the people used to paint those paintings on their walls. But here the Saura, if we take the Saura art was painted only by the priests of that area, and they were called the Edithalmars. These paintings were painted on the walls to please their ancestors and their deity, that was Edithal. They were known as ekons, and they follow the fishnet approach, and the geometrical borders are very, very important in these paintings. So here, whenever we see that there is a picture, we will see either the main subject of the painting will be either in the center of the painting or on the top. So here I am making the same border, repeating it, and I will place my main subject inside the circle that I have done. I have given it a pedestal position on top of the painting. So this painting that I am doing would be depicted a new house made, and then the painting is done. By looking at the painting, we actually can guess why and when it is done. So here I'm making this picture. This is the typical sun that we make in Saura art. All of them are symbolic and with no realistic resemblance. But yes, symbols are strong and they depict the main sense of it. Now this is an adobe hut. When a hut is made or on auspicious occasions, these paintings were painted by only the priest. That is one thing which is very different from that of Warli. So they have thatch roofs and mud walls. And here we'll just make some setting around. These were forest dwellers, and with many minimalistic things they used to survive. Generally they were hunters and gatherers, and we see that in their paintings most of the time. Now very important and commonly seen animal in these Saura painting is a monkey. We'll see a lot of monkeys, that is the main reason behind it. We can associate that in the forest, a lot many monkeys were there, and that is why it is shown in the picture. Now, Saura tribe didn't have any script where they can tell about themselves. So their paintings and their pictographs are the only source of knowing their culture. So again, we are following the same pattern, geometrical patterns, to divide the whole painting into small rows and columns. If you're liking my video, do not forget to subscribe and press the bell icon. You will get to know a lot about the history of the art and how would you connect to that. Now there's a basic difference in the figures that we make in Warli and Saura. Saura painting figures are very elongated and are thin structured. Possibly the reason that that race would be of that sort, that is why. Warli figures are very triangular and angular. The hands have the elbows and the legs have the knees as sharp bends. But whereas when we see Saura art, they are very, very flowy and fluid. Now, we are just changing the panels, and the second one, the first is going the celebration where the hut is made and the people are dancing. Now, the next one is there are four male members standing. Now, if you visit to my day two of my course, you will find what is the difference between a female and a male, how to make an old man, old lady, boy and a girl. And so you would better understand the concept very well. And here is the male figure. You can see that there is very minimalistic clothing on the bottom and elongated torso. So the upper body is long and they are holding the spears. The ladies are dancing and we are doing the same symmetrical design on the other side. Now, when a house was made, or whenever, if not a house, any good thing was being done, these paintings were painted and they were Idital Mars who used to come to do the paintings. While the painting was done, they used to sing hymns to please their ancestors and their deity that I told Idital. Now, while they were painting doing the painting, outside the house, there were feasting going on, dances going on, and they used to distribute the forest produce, whatever they had. So they had bananas, coconuts, honey. Those were distributed among the community, and the community used to come and the feast was prepared. So this was a small celebration that was done while the house was made. And these are the sitting postures of Idital Mars or the priests who are ready to be served with food. So we see one big similarity among Warli and this art is both of them have solid colored figures. And now the third panel goes with the offerings that were made. So we have made the two males. We often see that they are bent forward and they are curved figures, which is very unlikely in Warli. Now this is the animal being taken for the feast. Other produce like bananas, coconuts, goats, they were done and these offerings were made in front of the painting. So the painting here is not just a beautification of the adobe hut. It holds a lot of significance and respect to the community. So this is the banana. And here we are going to make a man taking the goat. So most of the figures, where they are moving, a left or a right, we will see that the chest is protruded to that side. So this is a basic difference that is there. And few elements are very, very common. If we take monkey, for instance, that is very common in Saura painting. And the figures are bent and fluid and flexible. So these are the major differences between Warli. So do not get confused. There is a lot to know about Saura. And if you are a person who is fond of Warli, then also you must know what is Saura, because then you will often get confused between those two arts. So they are very similar and I hope you like it. So we'll just do a little bit of beautification and hanging out of the monkey. The troop, the whole troop goes on the tips of the mountain or these hills or whatever these geometric triangles are symbolic of the range, the hills that they used to dwell on. So we'll just make the monkeys, and there is a big trail of monkeys mostly seen on the top of the hills or trees. If you are liking my video, do not forget to subscribe and support, and I'll keep making new videos with lot of educational stuff and will help you to know the art form better. We'll do some decorations on this. And we see birds on top of the trees or the constructions. There is one bird. I hope you like the video, and thanks for watching.